All right, we're at the airport. Double masked because there's a lot of people here. This is Sydney's first production, really third in Wonder. But we are headed to St. Louis for, why did you just do that little symbol? Mm-hmm. This is not Cartersville. But we are headed to St. Louis for a client production. St. Louis is a special city to me because it's the last place I saw my grandmother, who was in the hospital, who was also my very best friend. So I feel like this is a creative journey or a creative trip, but also a spiritual trip. All right, we're in St. Louis. So excited. I was double masked on the way here. It's not a single game. I should have had a or whatever, but we're in St. Louis. We're headed to Salt and Smoke. I'm so excited. I already feel the energy. Like Sydney asked you, she was like, how do you feel when you're here? And it feels like home. The last time I came here was 6 years ago though, but I used to always come up here between high school and college to see my grandmother. She was in the hospital up here after she got her, before she got her double lung transplant and after. So it feels good to be here. Where I last saw my grandma, but this is where I last saw her. Yeah, that's crazy. Barnes Jewish Medical. Her lungs were failing. My grandma was like a huge part of my life. Her lungs were failing, and so my aunt called me, and she was like, her sister called me and was like, hey, you should go up there and see your grandma. Like, it's getting close to the end. And so I ran up here, and this is crazy to kind of just be in the space. It's so weird. It's so weird to like, the idea of like somebody being here and then not being here is really crazy.
Especially since like she wasn't really from here.
No, but this was where me and her spent time. Like, I'm in Oklahoma, you know, I would have to go see Papa and stuff like that. But this is where me and her, me and my grandmother, it was just us. Oh my God, I feel like I'm, like the tears are coming because I just,
You remember coming here?
Yeah, and I was like, I was just so sad to leave when I had to leave. Because I knew that that was like gonna be it. Yeah, I was like, out here, I remember like trying to call my mom. Yeah, you can't go in anymore because of COVID, but I went up those stairs to go to like the food court and everything. Mm-hmm. I'll just pull up over here just to like.
So when you left, you were hesitant about leaving?
Well, I had to leave, right? But I mean, I was at an age where, and I didn't have to leave. I was at an age where all I wanted to do was like work and please my bosses. But like as an adult now, if things would have been the way they are, I would have stayed here until. I would have been with her every day. You gonna smile or something?
Why? I'm looking out the window.
This is gonna be in my vlog.
Why?
What are you saying? Wah?
This is a video?
Yeah. It's gonna be in my vlog.
About me.
I want people to see you in comfortable environments.
I thought a nigga who watch what I do, but he can't get his bitch back saying something. Is it true that he posting another nigga money? Probably. I'm put that past him. Maybe so. I thought a hoe that be speaking on me, but be fucking a broke nigga saying something. Listen. Hold up, little bitch. Get a nigga that's lit. I'm the whole loaf. He the breadcrumb.
This is my dog. Okay. So I just have a little.
Ooh. Okay. Ooh. Ooh, you ready? I'm having a I think that people don't really know this is work. Like, when we're filmed, like, people be exhausted at the end of our film days because we're filming. And we're not just, like, filming exactly what you would do on a normal day, right? Like, we're creating a story. We're telling a story that is natural, that is organic, right? But we're also thinking ahead. We're being, like, particular about, you know, what do we want to make sure that we get so that it makes sense? Because unless it's a vlog, like, a vlog can just feel behind the scenes, you know, like, mm-hmm. what I made for you, like, that's vlog style. Mm-hmm. But when you're doing a documentary series that's, like, TV ready, it's different.
It's work.
Why?
I said it's work.
I know.
I wanted you to find out why.
It's work. It's definitely work. Like, people are definitely
tired at the end of the day.
They're tired at the end of the day. Like, crew members are tired. Like, the actual talent is tired. Me and you weren't tired. We were like,
girl, I was tired as fuck.
Well, we went to the gym last night, like, after the shoot.
To try to get more energy. Because yeah.
But still, to have energy to go to the gym is like, I don't know. It's just.
No, I was. I guess I'm saying that just because, like, I wasn't expecting to be that tired. But, I mean, we also got things. We were traveling.
We could be working.
We're traveling as well. Yeah. So.
I just want to acknowledge that documentary series making is not just about documenting somebody. You know, like, it takes work. It takes thoughtfulness. It takes ideation. I've been working on these two shoot days since April. And I can't believe it's done. Like, I got in the car and I was like, look at my hair. I can't believe I'm showing y'all this side of me. But yeah, it's done. I'm happy it's done. Because it was excellent. It's like, we ended with the chicken head. That's crazy. What'd you say? She's mad. I got some. Okay, so I'm obsessed with, like, baking shows or whatever. And what are you doing?
I'm showing the people. The
okay. I'm obsessed with baking goods. So I ordered, like, a ton of baked goods from this place called Prioritized Pastries, and I spent like $40-something, and so later on today I'm going to do, like, a little challenge. They're vegan and gluten free, so I'm gonna try them. This is an example of a lemon cupcake, so we'll see how that goes. I'll be the only one trying things.
I got one thing in here.
She got one thing, so it's just gonna be basically.
What did I get?
You got a chocolate chip blondie. Second brain on alert.
One thing to know about me is I really, really love chocolate chips and chocolate.
She will eat anything that's like chocolate chips. Stop messing up my stuff.
Oh. You fell off.
That's why she don't need to be touching stuff. Is there forks and stuff in there?
Is that a blueberry muffin?
Yes. Are there forks and stuff in there?
I don't know.
Can you look?
1 second. I'm trying to put this thing like on. Like...
The fact that there's not is so annoying.
Why? What do you mean?
I want to try the blunt. The blunt.
Kind of blueberry?
Yeah, mixed
berry.
Mm-hmm.
Let me taste my blonde.
It's moist.
My blonde is so small.
Right. So let's see. This is a mixed berry blunt cake. Mmm.
I don't really have a flavor.
mine is packed with flavor. It's definitely dense, but I can tell it's mixed berries, and I really do enjoy that. Looks like it's filled. Let me see.
Let's keep taking bites to see if I taste some flavor.
And disappointed?
But you're doing good?
Mm-hmm. You want a bite?
Come
on. I knew it, and it's like, I don't want you to have one. I ordered three for me.
Y'all, look at this.
Stop, that's mine.
I'm not going.
Yeah, but I don't want your fucking fingers on it. I bought three of those for me.
Ooh, that looks good.
But you can have it now.
I don't want it.
Fingers. I don't. That's yours.
birthday in St. Louis. It's my grandmother's birthday, July 18th, my sweet cancer baby girl. And we are at the Arch. Because the Arch is very St. Louis. So we came down here. I've never been to the bottom of the Arch. So I just want to kind of talk to my grandma and see if I hear something from her while also doing something very St. Louis. My grandma. I don't like to use the word final, but this is the last stop that we're gonna make today to honor my grandmother. It's actually no longer Sweetie Pies. Sweetie Pies used to have a show on the Oprah Winfrey Network. I'm proud to say Jim and I came here before it was popping. Oprah has also been here. Me and my grandma used to come in. It used to be like a buffet, it used to be like soul food. A lot of people know that I'm dairy-free now, so I don't eat what I used to eat, but I used to get down on the mac and cheese here, on the cornbread here, like, it was just so good. So, this is it. This is Sweetie Pies. Sydney was like pointing to the sign right here, and I'm like, what are you pointing at? And we think it's a message from my grandma, because the last words that she said to me in her sickness and in her illness was, I love you. And there it says, I love you, I am with you, and you are not alone. I want to say something. Like, always follow your passion, y'all, because, like, had I not followed my passion, I wouldn't even get to have these moments here in St. Louis. Because I'm here filming for a client, but I get to be here on the 7th birthday without my grandma. Just experiencing her presence in a new way. So I'm so grateful.